So we're here. I just landed in LA. Seconds, I'm gonna say, the hours after the Jake Paul Ben Askren fight. What went through your mind? What did you think before the fight would happen?
Listen, I thought Ben Askren was gonna, you know, do it, but Jake Paul's a hell of an athlete. He came ready to go, and hats off to Ben Askren, Olympian. You know, you can't say any more than what he's done for the sport of MMA. So, you know, hats off to both fighters. They made their money. Was it a concert or a fight? I don't know. But Jake Paul did a hell of a job, and so did Ben Askren. So,
Jake Paul,
good job to both of them. It's a great show.
You're a professional fighter.
Yep.
You also work with the UFC gym, of course.
Yep.
But every fighter could take a note from Jake Paul. He's 3-0,
yep.
3 knockouts, but he's making millions and millions of dollars every fight, and it's all because of social media.
Yep.
So what would you tell fighters who are watching this? What could they do to enhance their social media?
Well, almost the opposite, right? Get to a point that you can actually do that, right? But at the same time, don't focus so much on that you're not training hard, right? Because you see, Jake Paul's in a spot where he's probably making the money. He can train hard, hire the right trainers, and not worry about all the other stuff. You got to worry about work. You got to worry about family. You got to worry about all the other stuff surrounding you. It's hard to concentrate on a fight because there's nothing more stressful than getting an octagon when somebody wants to take your head off. So, you know.
What was your record in MMA, professional record?
12-2.
And you were on a 10-fight win streak or something at some point? 11-fight?
Maybe 11. I don't know.
Something like
11-0. Something like that. Yeah. All submissions, yeah.
I remember.
Yeah, and so, yeah.
Ben Askren is a great wrestler. Boxing is not his strength. When I was watching him hit the bag or do pads, I thought he was trolling. I said, no one could be that bad. But, But that's who he was, and he tried his hardest, and he was smart enough, and I'm happy. People think the fight was staged or rigged. It's not.
It's not. No, he got hit.
He got hit, and he was rocked, and he was buzzed, and if the ref didn't stop it, it would have been ugly.
Well, Ben Askren is a hell of an athlete.
Yeah.
But, you know, not everybody has, you know, it's because they're an Olympic level athlete or they're a black belt in jiu-jitsu or they're, you know, they're a world champion in boxing. Doesn't make them great at another sport. You know, you have a world champion in boxing, won't do great at MMA or kickboxing even. You can have a Brazilian jiu-jitsu world champion, Olympic wrestler and enter the sport of striking, and they're not going to have the same success. It's all different. Everybody has their own skill set. At the ultimate, though, I'll tell you, is MMA. That is the sport of sports. You're going to fight anybody on the street or in the real life, it's MMA.
Okay.
It's not boxing. It's not Muay Thai. It's not kickboxing. It's not Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu. It's everything rolled into one.
All right. When am I coming to train with you? What are we turning me into? Like, what's after white belt? Yellow?
So me and Ellie have been talking on the phone. We've been FaceTiming. We've been
talking to my boy,
BJ Penn. We're going to train, we're going to get in the gi, and we're going to get ready. I'm headed to UFC gym, Midtown and Kendall right now over in Miami, and me and Ellie are going to get
I got to send you a little clip of an interview I did with Anderson Silva. A lot of people consider Anderson Silva the greatest ever, correct?
He's one of the GOATs, yes.
And I asked him, Anderson, who do you think is the greatest of all time? He said BJ Penn. That's a huge compliment. I'm going to send you the clip.
I love it. Yeah,
and you can send it to BJ.
BJ is, I love that. BJ is a hell of a guy. I think he's maybe BJ Anderson. I can name, you know, who knows who's the greatest. I don't think anybody's the greatest. But, man, you got your top five, top ten that really revolutionized the sport of mixed martial arts. And like I said, MMA is the real sport. Boxing, kickboxing, Muay Thai, Jiu-Jitsu. Everybody's got to go.
I'm
going to
run four fights by you. Tell me which fight you want to see Jake Paul. Do you want to see Jake Paul Connor?
Not Dylan Danis. No.
Not Dylan Danis? I didn't even get to him yet.
No, I don't want Dylan Danis.
Why?
I saw some stuff, huh?
Why?
He's another grappler.
Okay.
It's like another Ben Askren.
What about Dustin Poirier?
He's got a good
Dustin's
right
a boxer?
Dustin Poirier, I would see.
Conor McGregor
would be great. They're
Tyron Woodley?
Tyron Woodley would be great. Don't want to see Dylan Danis. Don't want to see a grappler. I want to see a striker against him. And Jake Paul, people don't understand. He's got hands. He's a great wrestler, too. He could probably fight in the UFC and give people a run for their money.
And you know all the UFC superstars. You work with them. You see them training.
I've seen.
And you say Jake Paul could be a UFC star?
I think he could do it. He's a hell of an athlete.
I've
seen him train. He's a hell of
Dana
an athlete.
Dana White said he would put $1 million that Askren would beat Jake. That's a lot of money.
Hey, I love Dana. Dana's the man. He's revolutionized, just sports in general. So, you know, is what it is. But I think Jake Paul would do a great job.
Tell everybody where to follow you on Instagram.
Brandon Logan Bender at Instagram, Bannon Bender at Facebook. You know, we're doing big things with UFC gym. Find a UFC gym near you.
And that was my next question.
Yep.
COVID, as you can see, I've been at this airport nonstop.
Yeah.
And this is the first time in a year and 2 months where it doesn't look like a ghost town. Because I travel nonstop. Usually it's nobody here. No one's about. Then it looks like COVID is over. So how, let me ask back to my question. UFC gyms, are they open now? Are they operating? I mean.
We're open, we're ready to go. Like I said, we're all about families. You know, the special thing about our gym that probably you're not gonna get from anywhere else is you can train or you can work out while your kid works out and trains too. And me, you know, growing up, martial arts saved my life. And I wanna instill that in the kids. So bring your kids. Let us teach them the value of martial arts and fitness and help them grow up healthy, as well as you do the exact same thing. But we can grow them up the right way.
There you have it. But I'm saying from operating standpoint, if there's a gym you call them up, you could go train, right?
Let's train.
There you have it. Stay tuned. FusedReporting.com. I'm Elie Seckbach reporting.